Hello everybody, I'm Dr. Arthur Mabonic. Welcome back to Let's Play Jack 2. If you live in Europe, Jack 2 Renegade. Last episode, we completed the test of manhood, but my game froze as we got to the cutscene where we can get to these the thing though, but let's retry, hopefully. And hopefully this, like, I dusted off the disc at this time. Hopefully this will work. I cleaned the disc. And we'll see what happens. There's a bit of some dust on there.
Daxter, there you are. What happened to you?
I had a hairy experience. No thanks to you.
Welcome, young warrior. Many eons have passed since our hope burned so brightly. Today, you have proven yourself worthy to receive Ma's legacy.
He's talking about me?
And this isn't like something from like my copy, too, because it worked on my older PS3s just fine.
The receive contains grave power. And with it comes grave responsibility. Eons ago,
there we go. Yeah. There we go.
With the Horaquan, those dark creatures we refer to as Metalheads, driven by their dark leader, the Metalhead Legions destroyed our great civilization, and now they swarm the universe unopposed, looking for the last relics of our power. Ma tried to hide the Precursor Stone in this tomb to protect it from them. It is our last hope. And you were chosen to keep that hope alive.
I think you got me confused with someone else. I just want the stone.
It is time to fulfill your destiny. Behold.
Wow! Let's get the goods.
Fools! You brought me right to the...
Oh, hi, Praxis.
The Grand Friends were no match for my guards above. Now I will gain the power I need to crush my enemies. And after claiming the stone... I'll begin with you.
And then I'm going to make some more Krabby Patties.
For you.
There, I need these stones. That way I can get some more money. Well, that's just me being an idiot.
Want some more? That's mine.
There we go, I just need to get myself a good position where I can destroy these drones. Let's see, now he shoots these bombs, which is the way you're supposed to attack him. You kick the bombs at him like they're a soccer ball, essentially. I thought I could kick it. It seemed like a good idea.
Try these arms. Your
Oh, my trajectory was a bit off. I think it exploded before it reached him, which sucks. But oh well, what can you do? Oh wait, it actually did hit him. And now he's gonna start trying to shoot us, which the best way to avoid that is to hide behind the pillars. Eh, give me more pain. Pain is good. Pain is very stimulating, I would be honest. But come on, hurt me more! Hurt me more, Praxis.
It's mine! My little friends will take care of you!
And it's kind of like a like you have to hide behind the pillars like you would in the Cerebulon fighting War of the Monsters. I need to call it damn good. And done by the guys who made the glorious Twisted Metal series. The glorious Twisted Metal series as well. They actually have like a little Sweet Tooth Mecha as like one of the unlockable characters, as an unlockable skin for one of the characters, if you have, a save file from Twisted Metal Black, which I do have.
Release it!
God damn it.
What's more?
Oh, the War of the Monsters AI at times can be outright bullshit. Mostly due to how cowardly they can get, when their health is low enough, they start running away, and they know where all the health packs are, and it can get really bloody annoying.
With the stone! My little friends will take care of you! You cannot win!
Let's see, now set out the bomb so that way it can kick them and destroy you. Asshole.
Give me the stone! With the stone! The stone is mine!
Let's see.
It's over.
Yeah, that's the last set of drones I need to worry about.
Special.
Oh, he took the stone. So yeah, this is how we're supposed to deal with him.
You cannot win!
Oh, no, convenient for the bomb to spawn right there, too. That was actually pretty damn convenient.
You cannot run forever!
And all you really have to do there is just simply jump over the... crap! And, you can simply jump over the bullet fire in this case, instead of having to hide behind the pillars all the time, which is actually really good.
Come here.
Got him. Let's see, I just need to kick one more bomb, and then Praxis is toppled. Essentially, this is a much easier fight than the one on the tower. There we go. Yeah, this actually wasn't too big a deal. And he still got the stone.
Nice try, but the stone is still mine. Don't worry, I will use the stone to its full potential. Soon all who oppose me will be destroyed by its power.
Oh, time for me to make more money in some Krabby Patties. Oh, hey, look, a precursor orb. And another one. So yeah, Praxis has a stone. We're screwed. Oh, that's mildly unfortunate, but hey, at least we get to start right here, though. And yeah, I can assure you that the freezing will most likely not happen ever again. I've had this game freeze a few times back in the day. But it's more like when it has... This is kind of the thing when it comes to games with dynamic loading, though. Because, like, since these games don't really have load screens and they load in the background, like with the airlocks and stuff. Then I did hear... Then the HD version does have a few quirks that aren't in the PS2 one, but they're very rare. If anything, they're more minor. They're more minor inconveniences in some cases. Then, like, also the disc was a bit dustier then, and we still have Yellow Crimson Guards, which I believe they take about 3 hits compared to their other contemporaries. Like, I had some fingerprints and stuff for reasons, which is kind of odd, because I don't really touch the bottom of my discs at all. I take really good care of my discs. But I fixed it. I dusted it off, and I cleaned it off, and then now we're back to the Let's Plays. Oh, and right as my heat died off, I ran into another guard, causing them to go after me again. Oh well.
Get more cruisers in here.
Yeah, life can be a bitch at times. Let's go talk to Torn.
How did the Baron know we were so close to making a move for the stone?
It's my fault. The Baron threatened to kill Ashlyn for spying. His own daughter. I couldn't risk that, even for the Underground.
Right. Very good thinking. Except Praxis has the Precursor Stone now, so he can do whatever he wants!
There is still a way to get our friends back. And maybe the Precursor Stone as well. I'll find Vin. Go to the fortress and we'll call you.
And why should we trust you?
Because you and I both know the Baron would have killed Ashlyn. It'll be a tough fight through the fortress. Probably suicide.
You just get that door open. I'll be there.
Smooth move, Torn, but then again, Ashlyn would have probably been a member of the Underground, a bit too valuable for... Wouldn't be exactly one considered expendable. Alright, let's go ahead and attack the fortress again, and this is the last real mission in the fortress.
It's us or them. There's no in between.
Don't worry, the Baron will save us.
I ain't got no faith in nobody. You're busted!
Let's see, there we go. Come on out and play, cowards. Come on and play! If only there's a mountain of corpses for Jack to be standing over. But we've effectively killed all the guards there. We massacred them all like a badass. Unlike dipshit Phil, where, as usual, he struggles with this mission. Let's see, now we get a platform across those turrets. Yeah, don't set them off, otherwise they'll blast you, obviously. I don't think I really need to explain how a turret works. Let's see, here's a jet boarding section. Around here, I remember, like, Phil thought he was in a new the same area all of a sudden, instead of a new area, just because he saw turrets. I mean, then again, this is Phil, and he's not exactly... Oh.
I need cover fire!
Well, it was worth the effort. A bit of an inconvenient spot, but then again, I don't really find the checkpoint placement. I mean, the checkpoint placement's a little bullshit, but it's more at most a minor inconvenience. There's only like very few missions where the checkpoint lacking can actually be a little aggravating, but again. Then again, just don't die as much, though, that you could argue that it's more or less incentive not to die. Because if you don't want to redo up the rest of the game, then just don't die. I mean, kind of like with Resident, the original Resident Evils, at least, where you had the increment. Where, like in the original Resident Evil, where you actually don't get continues if you get game over, and say you have to actually reload your last save, which was kind of more incentive to save, and even then you had the limited increments, which was incentives to save wisely. Like, because you could actually run out of increments, which actually did happen with DSP when it was playing Resident Evil 3 Nemesis, which for the record, I haven't really played it that much. Like, I only played a little bit of it because I bought it on sale, and I didn't really get into it. But, I'll probably look into it probably sometime in the future, because I did the original Resident Evil as my first Let's Play, and I kind of honestly wish I probably did something else. I mean, I like that game, it's fun, but I felt like that playthrough was not very well made. But, it's my first Let's Play, of course it's going to be a little rough around the edges. I'm trying to, that was kind of like when I was trying to find my, style. It's just more of a case of, it's inevitable. Let's see, I'm just gonna have my sniper. Actually, I'm just gonna put the gun up. Let's see, just got a platform on the turrets. Now, get my jet board ready. Really, I'm just gonna just go ahead. Yeah, you don't really need the jet board for that. Although it does help for that specific moment, though. Let's see, just simply a point where you have to run around the guard. And again, they have like stormtrooper style marksmanship, so they're not really a threat. I mean, at best, they're a minor inconvenience. See, I think we've... No, we haven't. KG Death Bots, eh? So yeah, now we're gonna start to see a bit more of some Death Bots. A set of KG drones that have only one purpose in life. To kill. Oh yeah, so we did make it. Gee, this looks familiar. Oh, hi, Tess.
Hey there, sweetheart. The Metalhead Masher has saved the day. Oh, and I let Jack tag along, too.
Oh, my little hero.
Seamus, are you alright?
What took you so long? I added 6 rings to my trunk waiting for you two to get me out of here. Great Yakow horns! What happened to you, Jack?
Wait a minute! You're you! I mean, the other you! I mean, you know what I mean.
Yes, it appears I have an older time twin. Great grass grubs. I can't believe what a cranky old log I've become.
2 Samos the Sages. Ah, Jack, they're multiplying.
We need to find the kid pronto.
What are you talking about, old growth? The kid already opened the tomb. Our top priority should be to disrupt the Baron's forces.
Oh, look who thinks they've sprouted. If you were half as wise as I am, you'd know that the proper course of action is to find the kid.
Listen, you old dried-up leaf. I run this outfit, and I say we go after the Baron's forces.
Do we have to separate you two?
Vin's activating the warp gate. We need to get out of here now.
So, yeah... Now there's 2 Samoses. And they don't like each other that much. Oh dear, I think I know what mission is nearby, but let's take a look. Because I think it's this a specific mission that I remember getting to as a kid, and I just outright quit the game then. That's because that's right around when a friend of mine actually gave me Pokemon Sapphire, and that just kind of more or less also became my top priority then. I mean, Phil had trouble with this, but I'm not going to really give him too much shit for this mission, because this is actually one of my least favorite missions in the entire game. I mean, mostly... What the hell? The music's not on. Huh. I just didn't notice that, but anyway. Oh god, I think I know... Yes, it is this mission. Oh, dear god, no. No! Is that his sewage in that pipe?
You boys are all right. And since the boss is out of it right now, I'm going to give it to you straight. I've been cruise heavy for years, and I've done some things I'm not proud of. But this time, I think Crew's gotten himself and us into something really nasty. I'm thinking of getting out.
Oh, Sig's beginning to like us, Jack. Come here, you big lug. Hugs for everyone.
Knock it off. I think Crew's trying to...
Relax. Watch me butter up Bun Boy. Hey there, stuffed crust! How's it feel floating on top of the food chain? Ooh, Crewmeister! Have you been exercising? You're looking good. You are definitely living large.
Mm-hmm.
And those legs! They're so chiseled.
I need you to escort 3 of my boys down into the sewers and visit that statue again. I've heard that Mars' cheeky face might contain another secret, and I want you to see if the stories are true, eh? Make sure all 3 of my boys get to that statue, and they'll do all the rest,
Oh no, this mission! An escort mission! And this is the one I've been talking about that was horrible. Oh, no, 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 no.
Moving to next sector.
This mission was so bad that I actually rage quit this game as a kid and didn't come back to it until I got the HD collection. When I was like 16, I hated this mission so much. I mean, that also, I got Pokemon Sapphire then, and again, that was kind of more my main priority. I mean, I was like stuck on this mission for a while. I mean, mostly because this is a very badly done escort mission and one where it's just ridiculous. We have to escort three idiot AIs that don't protect you. Oh my god, this. I am not looking forward to this. I am not looking forward to this mission. No, 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 no. However, this is however, the reward for completing this mission is pretty good, though, so I'll do it anyway. Might as well get it out of the way. It's like getting a needle from the doctor. It hurts, but get it over with. Like, this is going to be one of those moments where I'm not going to give Bill shit.
Okay, let's do this. Crew said you'll protect us all the way to the statue.
I got 30 minutes. The problem with these guys is that they don't help you out, like Sig or Ashlyn, where they normally help you defend yourself against anybody. These guys don't do shit, they just sit back on their ass, and you have to take all the battleheads for them. This would be fine if they were unarmed, but I clearly see them having guns. I mean, yeah, they destroy stuff that kinda help advance, but still. I mean, it's not about them dying, it's you're gonna die a bit more often than they are. So I'd recommend you save your Dark Jacks for this mission. It will help you out a lot. I will guarantee that. Like, you're gonna die more often than them just because they don't really protect you. And, like, they don't really have a good assistance. They don't really know how to fight properly. They're a bunch of freaking idiots.
All the way to the stack.
Like, I really hate this mission. I really hate this mission.
Just shut your whiny traps and keep moving. We go down.
I mean, their dialogue's somewhat amusing, but.
Did you hear that?
Shut up.
But this is not a saving grace of this horrible, horrible mission. Let's see, okay, I think.
We're clear! Let's move! This is where I come in. Cover your ears. This is gonna be loud. You better keep your head down, sugar. Ooh, that had to hurt. I told you to keep.
I thought I was out of range from that, but eh, what a.
They're coming up from behind, too.
Oh yeah, they'll come from behind, Tobe. But yeah, these guys are just.
You're pretty handy with that iron, Blondie.
Jack's my hero.
Shut up, Mog.
I got a bad feeling about this place.
I want to go home.
Ain't the spell.
Yeah, go home! So go home! That way I don't have to do this mission! This is just. Okay, at least here they're smart enough to stick behind and allow me to do the dirty work for them.
This place stinks.
Let's go, bud.
Here they come again!
Shoot, baby, shoot!
God, not even.
Magic, man.
I mean, people may complain in Resident Evil 4 about Ashley. At least she was smart enough not to get directly into enemy fire. You can at least tell her to hide if you need to.
Oh, I'm staying right here.
And shoot him.
Look at him.
Nice.
I couldn't have like
that. You win.
Ah, damn it. Then at least with Ashley, you can also heal her. And like with Ashley,
here comes
Resident Evil 4, I think, is one of those games that really did the escort missions right.
Crew said you'll protect us all the way to the street.
Like, I'm sorry if I'm starting to sound like Phil in this case, but this is just my least favorite mission in the entire game.
Just shut the wine traps and keep moving.
Wait, where are the other...
This way.
Oh. Very good point. I was like...
Shut up! Watch it, Chris! It's a metalhead!
What the?
Shoot it.
Man, that thing's ugly.
Idiot, you shot me, idiot. Next time, watch your aim. I'm the one keeping you assholes alive. You two aren't doing... Since you three idiots aren't doing shit. And I have to do your dirty work for you. I mean, people may go, the Earthworm, are you being a bit of a scrub? And the thing is, when you have a game where the majority of the escort missions are actually fairly well designed, and where the AI actually helps out, that's actually fit. And then you have this one where they're clearly armed, but don't really have any real assistance, then it's a bad... Then that's just a simply bad escort.
But no one ever listens. More of those monsters!
They're coming up from the door!
Great! Now we're back in the slime pit!
Take them on, good boy!
Let's go!
You're pretty handy with that iron, Blimey.
Jack, my hero.
Shut up, Mog!
Let's go back before we all get killed!
I wanna go home.
Ain't the smell of sulfur grand? Move your butts, or I'll move them for you.
This place stinks. Let's go back.
Here they come again!
Shoot, baby, shoot!
Let's see. Whew.
Magic, man.
And you guys don't, because you guys are freaking idiots.
Wow! Beans of death. I'm staying right here.
Yeah, at least you guys are smart enough to know that this is a bad idea to go rushing straight into enemy fire like freaking Leroy Jenkins. Yeah, don't you idiots pull any Leroy Jenkins shit on me.
Sweet as a ballerina.
Seriously, screw this mission. This mission is garbage.
Quiet. Here comes Pretty Boy. About time you showed up. Okay, let's do this.
I mean, people are going, Dr. Robotnik, shouldn't you use Dark Jack there? Thing is, I'm saying it for like a later part where there's an outright ambush.
Just shut your whiny traps.
It'll really help at the near the enemy.
This way. Shut up. I'll go ahead.
Get him, man, before he gets out.
Nice work. Those were some nasty metal hits. Ah! They're crawling down the walls!
But yeah, it's not like that they're gonna get killed, it's that you're more than likely to die just because these guys aren't really gonna help try to protect you. I mean, again, I wouldn't have a problem with this if they were unarmed, but the thing is, they're clearly armed with pistols. Say good fighter.
Boom, baby. You better keep your head down, sugar.
There we go. Now we got a good way to dodge that, just due to my learning capabilities. Unlike Phil. I mean, yeah, I said I'm not gonna give Phil shit for this mission, but I'm just saying that I'm just better at adapting to some situations than he is. And this is a mission that's just kind of outright bullshit. Take him out. And this is one of the very rare moments when they actually do help, but that's not enough. That's not enough to redeem them for me.
Let's go back before we all get killed.
I wanna go home.
Yeah, go home, buddy. Go home. I don't like you. I don't like this mission. I do not like this mission at all. It's my least favorite mission in the entire game. This is about as... This is like up there with thy flesh frickin' consumed! I mean, I don't... I apologize for my anger, but this is just... This is just madness! This is just ridiculous!
Wow!
I'm not even gonna try to channel my usual film mocking tone, because I hate this mission with a burning passion. I mean, yeah, my deaths are my fault, but that doesn't change the fact that this mission is just annoying as hell. Due to the fact that the AI does not help.
Keep moving! Get back! I'm gonna get me this one remote. Coming out. Stay close, pretty boy.
Let's see. Yeah, now we're near the end.
You hear that?
Sounds like I got kids.
Ah! The ceiling's crawling!
Jack! Metalheads everywhere!
It's a trap!
Okay. That's at least admittedly a little amusing hearing. Although I don't really doubt, I doubt that that's an outright reference to the infamous Admiral Akbar. Oh crap, one of them. Ah crap, he died. I was about to activate him, but then he died. Damn!
All the way to the statue.
I got 30 keys of ice strapped to my back. Great.
Yeah, why did we sign up for this?
Just shut your whiny traps and keep moving. We go down!
Do we have to?
Buddy, get on there!
Hey, man, what?
Okay, I deserve that. However... I'm gonna need to restart this, because the AI apparently farted out or something. The AI just simply...
Wait, here comes Pretty Boy.
Both just wasn't asked for that during
okay,
that.
Let's do this. Crew said you'll protect us all the way to the statue.
I got 30.
Considering that these AIs are already idiotic, I'm not surprised.
Yeah, why did we sign up for this?
Just shut your whiny traps and keep moving.
There we go. Hold on a minute, that guy's armor is kind of cool.
Did you hear that?
We are so dead.
Shut up! Shoot it!
I mean, no, this mission does not tank my enjoyment of this game. I would like to point that out. I love this game a lot, still. I'm just so sorry for my anger. It's just that this is easily it's just one of those moments of a good game that's just very annoying to deal with. Then I think I will. I think I will begin one of my usual mocking zones. But I mean, even the harder missions I at least liked, like the one where you had to like destroy the Hellcats and stuff. Those were pretty cool. Or the dig, where that one was a little frustrating, but that's more of a case of due to the fact that the KG shit.
You better keep your head down, sugar.
man, Jinx, what did you put in those boomsticks?
You bet.
I mean, we have a trio that makes the Aqua Teen Hunger Force look like freaking geniuses in comparison. Well, then again, the Hunger Force has Firelock, who would probably do something stupid like this. But, like, you have these guys that make Master frickin' Shake look like a frickin' Einstein.
You're pretty handy with that iron, Blondie.
I mean, it's evident I hate these characters just because of their idiot AI and the fact that this mission is as absolute garbage.
Ain't the smell of sulfur grand?
Come on. Let's get this mission over with. Otherwise, I will smash you. Now, I'm not gonna smash my controller or this game. This game is awesome. I love this game. But this mission is not great.
Here they come again.
Shoot me, shoot.
You know, I'm not allowed to score anything. It's just that I just have limits, and this is my limit. I just want to make that clear. I have my limit and my.
You got the magic, man. Wow,
like, this is just one of those moments where my buttons are just being pushed. Am I going like with the feeling like I'm pressing buttons? No, I mean my actual literal buttons are being pushed by this frickin' mission. Like, this is frickin' hell. This mission is hell. Oh, I'm out of scattergun. I'm out of scattergun ammo. Blaster ammo. I never would have ever expected that in a million years. But I got plenty of Vulcan Fury to go around.
One unclogged sewer coming out. You hear that?
Sounds like I got gas.
Sounds like that this mission sucks ass.
Metalheads everywhere.
It's a trap.
I'm just gonna stand right here and just simply massacre them all. Come on, please. This should be hopefully this is enough to kill them all and end this frickin' mission.
Let's get out of here before more come back. You're ending your throw today. Let's finish this.
Please be the end. Please be the end. I hope this is the end. I hate this mission. Yes, we made it. We made it. We made it. I don't have to see these assholes ever again.
Pretty statue.
Stand back. We're professionals. All right, boys, let's blow this sucker sky high.
Wait, who told you to... No!
There's what we're looking for. The heart of my gym. Thanks for the escort, buddy. We'll take it back to crew.
We have beaten this frickin' mission of frickin' endurance.
For your loyalty, your fire, and excellent gun upgrade stashed in a crate in the port.
Am I going the wrong right? Okay, yeah, I am going the right way. Let's go collect our reward, and then that way we can conclude this part. Whew, we beat the mission finally. We finally beat that mission. There we go. And we don't have to see that trio of incompetent idiots ever again. I swear, I remember people being more competent in my high school. And I had frickin' idiots there too. especially in my English class in my junior year. Let's see, now let's get our reward. Fair, I'm just gonna punch him, I'm just pissed off.
Care to try for the match record?
And we got the final gun we got the final weapon. The Peacemaker. Which is essentially a rocket launcher.
Our own Peacemaker! Now we're rocking!
So yeah, it's a good reward if you ask me. However, now I need to refill my gun ammo. Anyway, I'm Dr. Arthur Ramonic. I thank you for watching this part, and I do thank you for able to putting up my anger with that one frickin' mission. See you guys next time.